Great day, everyone. It's a Darrel Mohan coming at you all. It's a beautiful day here in Trinidad and Tobago, beautiful Wednesday. And I'm here with my two boys, Darius and Isaiah. So we are just out doing some errands and, you know, just decided to come on here and I wanted to speak with you all about something that is in my spirit. So while we are waiting for the live to build, boys, say hello.
Hello.
So they are riding with me, guys. They are riding with me today, right? And you know, one of the things that is on my spirit, and you will see the heading of this live for today, is Satan doesn't take vacations. Okay, so we're going to be talking about that. We're going to be discussing that a little bit in terms of, you know, what we should be doing as we enter into 2022. Now, you know, yesterday and the day before, my wife and I, Renu, we were doing some household cleaning, like most people. Cleaning, washing down, mopping, maybe even doing some painting, maybe even doing some cobwebbing or rearranging, whatever the cases that you are doing. And you know, this is the time of the year that a lot of people, they go on a cleaning frenzy. A lot of people, they decide that, you know what, everything needs to be washed down, everything needs to be clean, spick and spang, as we say here in Trinidad. So you want to do over back everything, you want to buy new curtains, you want to mop, you want to, you know, everything needs to be rearranged and get rid of the old as you welcome the new. And you know, while we were cleaning yesterday, you know, the Lord just pressed into my spirit that just as many people are busy right now, this time of the year, it's a busy time of the year. December month throughout the entire world, it's a busy time. You're going to see a lot of people doing a lot of shopping, preparing for the new year, things like that. But I want to remind you of something. While you are being, you know, yourself and, you know, you want to take care of your home and your family and you're all about running around being busy, we need to understand something, that the devil, he doesn't take any vacations at all. I want to say that again. A lot of us, we will be busy during this time, and nothing is wrong with that. Nothing is wrong in doing your cleaning. Nothing is wrong in you, you know, putting your home together. Nothing is wrong with you going and buying your stuff for the holidays or whatever the case is. But I want to remind you that while you are doing all these things, take the time out to pray. Take the time out to spend time with God. Because while you are busy, quote unquote, the devil is also busy. While you might be thinking that, you know, this is a time to relax, throw back my feet. You know, I've worked whole year. Many people will say that, you know, I've worked whole year. And December month is a month that I'm going to take some time for me and my family and to do all these different things. Welcome, Hema. Lots of birthdays too. Yes, that's correct, Hema. My birthday is this month. Don't forget. Well, I know you remember the boys, but my birthday is this month. And they are laughing. Right, Auntie Hema says hello. Welcome, Tracy. Glad to have you here on, sis. Welcome, Sister Yvonne. So we need to understand something. Yes, nothing is wrong, as I said, in doing what you need to do. Nothing is wrong in buying gifts. Nothing is wrong in you preparing your home. Nothing is wrong in you going and doing your Christmas shopping. But the devil, we need to understand something. And for all those who will be watching on the replay, the devil does not take vacations. I want to say that again. While you are busy, he is busy planning and plotting his next assault over you and your family. You don't believe me? The Bible says what? That the enemy, His goal is to steal, to kill, and to destroy. And if he cannot steal, kill, and destroy, he will try to get you busy so that he will come unannounced and he will get you caught off guard. And that is what happens to a lot of people many times. They get caught off guard and they do not see where the enemy is coming from. Welcome, Sister Yvonne. Glad to have you here. And that's it. Many people, they will be distracted so much so that they will take the entire Christmas season out. They will take the entire December month and they will be, you know, watching their Hallmark movies and doing whatever they have to go, visiting family, driving and doing all that they have to do, not realizing that if you are called by God, you have a plan and a purpose for your life. God has called you to do great and mighty things for him. You cannot afford to be distracted. You cannot afford for the enemy to catch you off guard. And I've seen this time and time again where during this time, people dress back and they relax. And again, I'm not saying nothing is wrong with that, but you have to be vigilant. You know, our team for this month in our church, MHOP, Macmean House of Prayer, our team for this month is be vigilant. And you have to be aware. You have to be very, very aware and vigilant of the enemy and his strategic tactics in this season. Welcome, Pastor Jess. Glad to have you here. Sister Tracy, yes, these guys, they're rolling with me today. Right, Darius and Isaiah. So, do not get so distracted, friends and family all over the world, that the enemy comes in like a mighty rushing wind and he causes chaos and he causes confusion and he is out to destroy you and your family. This is a plot of the enemy. The enemy wants us to be distracted. Come on. The enemy wants us to be distracted from our assignment. The enemy wants us to be distracted with house cleaning and housework and cooking and gift wrapping and all these different things. And as I said, nothing is wrong with that. But we need to understand that once you are called to be a child of God, once there is destiny locked up on the inside of you, once you understand your divine assignment, the enemy, let me tell you something, the enemy does not care about shopping. The enemy doesn't care about you doing your cleaning. All he wants is a little loophole. Are you seeing that? Are you seeing the hole that I make with my fist? All the enemy needs is a little hole like this, because the enemy is like a snake. And as the snake gets his head wrapped in and his head through that little hole, he comes in and he takes control. Pastor Jess, yes, Pastor Jess says she's seeing you, Darius. Right? So that's it. That's it. A tiny, tiny hole the enemy needs. That's it, Sister Yvonne. And the enemy will come and you will be so amazed. You're asking yourself a question, but how did the enemy come in? Where did the enemy come from? Where did the enemy come from? And that is, to all that is looking on, we just lose focus of what we were supposed to be doing. When we were supposed to be praying, when we were supposed to be fasting, when we were supposed to be spending time in the Word of God, we were distracted. And that is what the enemy is going to do for a lot of people in this month of December. He's going to cause a lot of people to be distracted. A lot of people to be, you know, to get caught up with the Christmas season and all these different things, right? And as I said, you need to be very, very vigilant of the strategic times that we are living in. Be very mindful, saints. Be very, very mindful. Say hello. Don't put your hands in the camera, yeah. Right? Look, your teacher is here, Miss Vidya. She's watching you. Right? So I just want to encourage everyone. I want to encourage everyone that is looking on. Do not get distracted. Do not get distracted. Do not get distracted. You realize how many times I'm repeating myself to you? Because once the enemy gets that little tiny hole, he's going to come in. He's going to run havoc into your home. And then guess what happens? You will now be paranoid because you are wondering, well, where did he come from? You just got distracted. So, yes, enjoy the December month. Yes, spend time with your family. Yes, do all the things that you need to do to prepare yourself and to prepare your home. But I'm saying to you again, everyone, try your best not to get distracted. When you are going out and you are driving, I am telling you, this time of the year, bandits are all over the place. You will not believe how much people are looking at you when you are moving around. Be very careful. Watch, look around before you come out of your vehicle. If you are shopping, be very, very careful. You are driving home and you are coming home late. Look to and fro, right? Check your surrounding. Have that militant mindset. I'll say that again. Have that militant mindset. We are called in the army of the Lord. And as a good soldier, you should have total awareness of your surrounding. You know, when I go out to the road, I will be so cautious, mindful of my surroundings. And that's it, Pastor Jess. Yes, don't get carried away. All the enemy needs is an entry point. Cover yourself. When you are leaving home, I want to encourage everyone that is looking, be very, very alert. Cover yourself. Pray before you leave home, before you start that vehicle. Pray and ask the Lord to cover you. You might just be going to the grocery. You might just be going to the vegetable stall. You do not know how this enemy operates. Many people think that the enemy is just, you know, he just like to play games. No. The enemy is out for blood. The enemy is out for blood. So that's why I said, have a militant mindset. Be extremely careful out there. But don't get so distracted that the enemy comes in and he runs amok in your entire family. All right? I want to wish everyone a happy holiday. Yes, you know, you're going to be doing all these things. But, you know, at the same point in time, we need to be reminded at times how this devil works. He's very sneaky. That's it, Sister Yvonne. The enemy is very, very sneaky. That's it. So, hope everyone is having a great day. Be very careful when you are moving around. All right. Yes, we have all these different variants to deal with right now. Omicron is all over the place. But, you know, social distance, sanitize. Do what you have to do. But be very, very vigilant, okay? And if you are looking for a local church, for all my friends that is looking on, and you don't have a local church, maybe you want to spend the All Year's Night in a church and you don't have a church, get in contact with me, right? Our church is McBean House of Prayer, MHOP. And yes, I am one of the ministers and the reverend there, together with my senior apostle, Apostle Dr. Darren Rambley, and my pastor, Pastor Dr. Jessica Rambley. Right? Let us make sure that we are alive to see 2022. Let us make sure that we are vigilant. And let us make sure we are not distracted, where we could give the enemy a foothold into our life. Okay? So be very vigilant, friends and family. For those who are looking on, this is Reverend Darrel here just saying, have a blessed day. God bless you. And I'll see you all soon.
Bye-bye.
Darius and Isaiah is very excited to be on this live. Tell them bye.
Yay!
Take care, everyone. Bye.